A reading from the Gospel according to Luke. After his baptism, Jesus, full of the Holy Spirit, returned from the Jordan and was led by the Spirit into the wilderness, where for 40 days he was tempted by the devil. He ate nothing at all during those days, and when they were over, he was famished. The devil said to him, "If you are the Son of God, command this stone to become a loaf of bread." Jesus answered him, "It is written, 'One does not live by bread alone.'" Then the devil led him up and showed him in an instant all the kingdoms of the world. And the devil said to him, "To you I will give their glory and all this authority, for it has been given over to me, and I give it to anyone I please. If you then will worship me, it will all be yours." Jesus answered him, "It is written, 'Worship the Lord your God and serve only him.'" Then the devil took him to Jerusalem and placed him on the pinnacle of the temple, saying to him, "If you are the Son of God, throw yourself down from here. For it is written, 'He will command his angels concerning you to protect you, and on their hands they will bear you up, so that you will not dash your foot against a stone.'" Jesus answered him, "It is said, 'Do not put the Lord your God to the test.'" When the devil had finished every test, he departed from him until an opportune time. Here ends the reading. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. We are in Lent. We are in Lent, and here we go, first Sunday of Lent. I love this story. It is such an easy one to preach on. It's got three temptations, temptations about food, temptations about ruling everything, and temptations about how to treat God. Jesus answers every temptation, but what's interesting, I don't know if you caught it at the end, after the devil finished all the tests, so we only heard of three. There might have been 20. Might have been the SAT of Jesus Christ. Who knows? But anyway, these three. They speak to how to use power. They speak to how we will be asked to use our power. And here is what we proclaim as the most powerful one, the Son of God, somebody with all the power to heal, the power to do miracles, the power to feed. And this young man is being asked what to do with his power, which is basically to give it away and use it for other purposes, for selfish purposes, for to either feed himself or to proclaim himself. And I just like that idea. And there's a little word that I always pay attention to whenever I see it, where the devil says, "Do this because all authority has been given to me and I will give it to you." The word authority is an awesome word. It has its roots in our Latin cousin, or our Latin great-great-great-grandfather. It means to write. And those who have authority are authors. They write the rules. They have the authority to enforce the rules they wrote. And for those who live into the rules, they live into, oddly enough, an authenticity. Authenticity, authority, and author, same root. And here we have Jesus being tempted about what to do. Whose authority does Jesus live under? Does he live under the adversary or the devil, or does he live under his Father, the God Almighty? And how will Jesus use his authority? What's interesting is that when Jesus ascends into heaven, Jesus does something. He gives his authority away. He gives it to the disciples, turns them into apostles, and tells them to go. And the authority from which Jesus gives those first apostles has trickled all the way to 2022 to you and to me. And we have an authority to resist temptation. We have the ability to live authentic lives, not just as Christians, but in ourselves as human beings. The Christian is different. Our baptism set us apart. We are different for a reason, and it's not, you'll be surprised to hear, to an insurance policy in order to get into heaven. We Christians are asked to do something, and that is to bring the kingdom of God into fruition, or excuse me, bring the kingdom of God now, not to fruition. Maybe that's the right word. But we're to do it now. We have the authority to do it now. You and I, we have the ability, the authority to live authentic Christian lives by resisting the powers of the world, which corrupt and destroy the creatures of God, and embracing our faith as Christians. We have the authority to heal, the ability to heal, to make the world whole, to feed the whole world, to make the whole world know that God is good and that this gospel is unique and that this gospel is sound. This gospel that we proclaim is prophetic, and this gospel that we proclaim is good. So as you make your journey into Lent, know that you are people under authority, the authority of Jesus, and you are being asked to live authentic lives. You are not to live lives that prop yourselves up, but you are to live lives that proclaim God and show the world who Jesus is. Amen. Let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Lord Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, we pray you to set your passion, cross, and death between your judgment and our souls, now and in the hour of our death. Give mercy and grace to the living, pardon and rest to the dead, to your holy church, peace and concord, and to us sinners, everlasting life and glory. For with the Father and the Holy Spirit you live and reign, one God, now and forever. Amen.